not going to continue be able to continue to employ as many people. The other thing they may do, believe it or not, is businesses may just decide to drop their health care plan for all their employees altogether. Came out this week, McDonald's, I don't know if you saw it in the paper, but McDonald's Corporation this week said, you know what? We're probably going to drop our health care plan for all of our employees because it's cheaper for us to just pay the penalty to the federal government. So what kind of a system is that? And what that's going to lead to is all of those people now, instead of having quality private sector health insurance, are going to have to depend on Medicaid or other government support, which is not quality health insurance like they had. AT&T said the same thing. They said, they look at it, the penalty may be one-fourth of what their cost for their health care is. Not only for their current employees, but for their retirees. So you've worked your whole life for this, for a company. You've contributed. You're a retiree. And it'll be cheaper for them to just not provide the health care insurance they said they're supposed to, because it's cheaper just to pay the penalty to the federal government. So I see the healthcare bill bad for business, bad for job creation at a time when we have the highest unemployment rate in history for so many months. And we have a real low tax base because nobody's being employed. That part of it's bad for is bad. On the healthcare side, the healthcare bill is gonna lead, I think is gonna lead eventually to mostly government coverage for all of us. And I don't know about you, but I'm over the years, I'm 48 now, I haven't yet to identify very many programs the federal government's really great at. Okay, there are a lot of good programs. But every program right that you know that we have related to healthcare right now is struggling. The healthcare bill cuts $500 billion from Medicare. You know, the system that provides health care for our seniors, they're going to cut $500 billion from that system. One that's already struggling to stay afloat. So from a health care standpoint, you can expect less service, less access, and eventually potential rationing. Because every government system in the world that has a government-run health care system, at some point, based on money, has to decide, make decisions about what service they provide for people. And when you do that, that's rationing healthcare. So those are the three big reasons why I'm in this race. I really believe strongly in private sector people running for office. I have a great deal of respect for all the candidates here tonight because I've found, I knew this going in, but I found that, you know, to step up and put yourself out there and run for office, take some criticism, and stand by your beliefs is tough. So every candidate in this room that's running for office deserves our greatest respect. The fact of the matter is, any candidate on either side of the aisle that's running, we may not agree with them, but they've put themselves out there, and that's a tough thing to do, and I applaud every candidate in this room tonight for putting yourself out there and standing up for your beliefs. A couple other things I'll touch on real quickly. The cap and trade legislation, obviously I'm against. In Indiana, and I found this out because I toured a coal mine in Gibson County. My dad was a coal miner. And I hadn't been down the coal mine in 30 years. He took me down there when I was in high school. We just went down to Gibson County Coal outside of Princeton.